Excuse me, who are you?
I'm Magpie. I want to be your friend.
Well, I only make friends with pretty girls. No one is as pretty as I am.
Peacock, you are too proud. When you looked into the lake, you saw your reflection. It wasn't really you.
What a handsome man. Oh, 抱歉，都忘了跟大家打招呼了。Hello, everyone. Welcome to E4 Teens. I am Jack. 我跟那只孔雀可是不一样的哦。我一点都不臭屁，只是自我感觉有那么一点点的非常良好。OK， 不过好汉不提当年勇，虽然以前还有导演找过我要拍罗密欧呢。Because I am tall and handsome. OK， 今天的 Story Time 里，大家都想要抢着当罗密欧与朱丽叶，到底谁会是最佳男女主角呢？让我们来当一下毒舌评审吧。
For Romeo and Juliet today. If we do well, we can be in the play.
Really? That's wonderful.
I want to play Juliet. She's beautiful. So am I.
Then I'd like to be Romeo. She is so cool. Then I am too.
I'm a shy person. What role can I play?
I don't know.
Ooh.
Here comes Mr. Wong. Maybe you can ask him.
Hi, everyone. Today, we're going to choose actors for our play. If you act well, you can be in the play.
It sounds exciting.
Mandy, you go first. Please play an old, successful businesswoman.Now, she's angry at her son's bad grade. Okay, stop. Now, it's your turn, Steven. Can you play a funny blind monkey?He's going mad because he's hungry. Okay, stop. Guys, take it seriously, okay?Are you sure you want to be in the play? You're driving me crazy!
Hey, Kay, 如果是你, which role would you like to play?
我想要演 Juliet. I want to play a kind and smart girl. 一个冰雪聪明的女孩. Patricia, 那你呢?
我想要演 Romeo. 我想要颠覆传统, 演一个 poor but funny Romeo.即便我一贫如洗，一定还是会有人欣赏我的优点。我那么有趣又搞笑，我相信还是能够找到真爱的。
I'm sure you will. 不过我们两个刚刚讲了那么多 smart, poor, kind and funny， 不知道同学们懂多少呢？这些都是形容词，用来描述一个人的特质。今天呢，第一节我们就来学学跟个性、情绪或人格特质有关的单字吧。
说到情绪 ，K， 前些日子我碰到我们的好朋友 Irene， 她说 she gets angry more often than before， 她现在越来越容易生气耶。
同学们， angry 是生气的。She gets angry more often than before. 她比以前更容易生气动怒。类似的意思还有 mad. For example, Jack's mother got mad because he went home late. Jack 的妈妈因为 Jack 晚回家而生气动怒。So, why does Irene get angry more often than before?
她说啊，最近工作不顺利，就变得很容易生气，一直觉得自己不够好。
哎呀，她应该多看看自己的优点啊。比如说，她待人都很亲切呢，这是大家都有目共睹的。She is a nice and friendly person, and everybody likes her.
Nice 是很好的意思， friendly 则是很友善的。She's a nice and friendly person, and everybody likes her. 这句话的意思是她人很好，待人也很友善，大家都很喜欢她哦。
不仅如此， She also has a kind heart. Her pet Lucky was a stray dog. 她很有爱心哦，还带流浪狗回家呢。而这里的 have a kind heart 指的是有好心肠。 Kind 是好心的，仁慈的意思。
是啊，我们都要多欣赏自己的优点和长处哦。其实像 Kay 你也很棒哦。 Kay's so smart that she can answer any riddle. Kay 是这么的聪明，任何的谜语她都猜得出来。同学们，这里的 smart 是聪明的意思，它的相反词是愚笨的， stupid。For example, I was so stupid that I missed the easy question. 我好呆哦，居然连这么简单的问题都不会。
Patricia, 谢谢你的赞美。再来，我们看 hardworking 这个字。Hardworking 是努力的。举例来说， Joe is a hardworking teacher. He works around the clock. Joe 老师啊，是一位勤奋的老师，日以继夜的工作。Hardworking 的相反词则是 lazy, 懒惰的。Tina is very lazy. She seldom cleans her room. Tina 很懒惰，她很少整理房间。
不过说到 Joe 老师，他的勤奋是丁杠五名声 A 杠熊村名哦，他还很搞笑呢。Joe's very funny and he always makes people laugh. 他总是逗得大家哈哈大笑。这里的 funny 是有趣的、好笑的意思。
除了这些单字啊，我们还要学另一类表达情绪的形容词。举例来说， Joe's students are crazy about him. They always get excited when he walks into the classroom. Joe 的学生很迷他的呢，每当 Joe 走进教室，他们都变得超兴奋的。这里的 crazy 指的是疯狂的，对事情很着迷的。Excited 则是指感到兴奋的。
知道为什么吗？ Joe's English class is exciting. He plays a lot of interesting games with his students. Joe 的英文课总是很刺激，他总在课堂上玩有趣的游戏。Exciting 是令人感到兴奋的、刺激的。Interesting 是令人感到有趣的。像 exciting 或 interesting 这样 ing 字尾的形容词，多半描述事情令人觉得怎么样的状态。
Joe's students are very interested in the games he plays. 知道这句话什么意思吗？ Joe 的学生对他课堂上玩的游戏很感兴趣。讲到人对事物感到有兴趣的状态，我们则是用 interested， 对什么事物很感兴趣的。
刚才有个句子， Joe's students are interested in the games he plays. 我们也可以换句话说， His students are never bored with the games. 这里的 bored 则是人对事物感到无聊的，感到厌烦的。他的学生啊，可从来不会对这些游戏感到无聊哦。
此外，我们一开始提到的 poor 还没解释呢。I'm poor, but I'm happy.我虽然穷，但是我很快乐。Poor 是指贫穷的、没有钱的。我虽然穷，但是我有一群天真活泼、聪明可爱的学生，他们是我快乐的泉源呢。
Poor 的相反词是 rich， 是指有钱的。A rich person may not be happy。有钱的人虽然拥有金山银山，但也不见得会快乐。同学们，如果能够知足常乐，也是可以很成功、很幸福的哦。 不知道到最后是谁能得到 Romeo 这个角色呢？我好好奇哦。
我们先复习一下这节所学的单字，再继续看下去。
谢谢 Kay and Patricia 这两位 lovely girls 的讲解。现在跟大家玩个简单的小游戏。Are you ready?If John works hard, he will become a businessman someday. 这个答案是什么呢？ That's right. If John works hard, he will become a successful businessman someday. 如果 John 努力的工作，有一天他会成为一位成功的商人。If John works hard, he will become a successful businessman someday. Next.Jonathan gets doing the same thing again and again. He can't stand it. 这个是什么答案呢？ Very good. Jonathan gets bored doing the same thing again and again. He can't stand it. Jonathan 因为一直重复同样的事情，觉得很厌烦了，再也受不了了。Jonathan gets bored doing the same thing again and again. He can't stand it. For the audition, everyone is full of effort. But Mr. Wang wants to play the character is too challenging. A funny blind monkey? Steven, you are really good.
Are you ready, Alex? It's your turn now.
I'm ready. What role should I play?
A cute girl who is a little heavy. She feels lonely.
I will try my best.
Always careful when he crosses the street.
Got it!
Bravo! You can win an Oscar!
Thank you!So, can both of us be in the play?
No problem.
Woo! Are we going to play Romeo and Juliet?
No.
What about their parents?
No.
Their friends?
No.
So, what roles are we going to play?
Because we already have Romeo and Juliet, their parents and their friends in the play, you can only play trees.
What?
Just kidding.
同学们，我们在前一节看了内在，聊了很多个性及情绪的形容词。这节啊，我们来学学跟外表有关的形容词。Patricia， 你觉得外表重要吗？
说到外表啊，我想到最近有很多瘦身的新闻呢。Some girls used to be fat, but they look thin and beautiful now.听说他们持续的运动跟控制饮食，现在身体变得健康又苗条。刚刚提到 fat 指的是胖的，讲一个人 fat 肥胖有一些失礼。有些时候我们还可以用 overweight 过重的来委婉表达哦。那么 fat 的相反词是 thin 瘦的。The models on TV look too thin。电视上的 model 看起来都太瘦了啦。他们不知道有没有吃东西啊，长得那么高又那么瘦，希望他们还是要有均衡的饮食，身体才能够负荷得了哦。哎，讲到高，同学们知道高怎么说吗？举个例子，
It's easier for tall basketball players to get the rebound.
长得比较高的篮球员比较容易拿到篮板球哦。
那么 tall 的相反词是 short。Although Jimmy is short, he can play basketball very well. He's a good point guard. Jimmy 虽然长得不高，但是篮球打得很好，是个很不错的控球后卫哦。
大部分的模特除了高，外表通常也出色。那要怎么形容一个人的美丽呢？对了，我们可以用 beautiful， 美丽的、漂亮的。Wendy looks beautiful in that pink dress. Wendy 穿那件粉红色洋装看起来很漂亮。若是邻家女孩般的甜美，我们可以用 cute 来形容哦。Lucy is a cute little girl. 除了 beautiful 和 cute， 还有一个字 lovely， 也可以用来形容外貌哦。Lovely 是可爱的、迷人的。You look lovely this evening.你今晚看起来很迷人。和这些美丽可爱的形容词相反的词是什么呢？对了，是 ugly， 指的是丑陋的。同学们记得丑小鸭的故事吗？
我记得 The ugly duckling became a beautiful swan when it grew up。 丑小鸭长大之后就变成美丽的天鹅咯。
Right， 所以同学们可别以外表来评断一个人哦。外表啊是会改变的，可是一个人的内在更重要。
Beauty is but skin deep， 美丽是肤浅的，心地善良、真诚待他人的内在美才是真正永恒的哦。
See you next time.
Are you ready?
Kelly has got a baby brother. Many people like to play with him. 这个答案是什么呢？Very good. Kelly has got a cute baby brother. Many people like to play with him. Kelly 有位很可爱的弟弟，很多人喜欢跟他一起玩。Kelly has a cute baby brother. Many people like to play with him. Next. Although Jenny and Mary are, they can play basketball very well.Jenny 跟 Mary 怎么样呢？ That's right. Although Jenny and Mary are short, they can play basketball very well. 虽然 Jenny 跟 Mary 都很矮，但是他们打篮球还是很厉害的。Although Jenny and Mary are short, they can play basketball very well.看到 Alex 和另外三位同学表演的那么精彩，我突然寄养来演一个可爱女人在找她遗失的青春好了。
我的青春呢？我的青春小鸟一样不会离开。
Like to be Romeo. He is so cool. And I am too.
I'm a shy person. What role can I play?
I don't know. Ooh. Here comes Mr. Wong. Maybe you can ask him.
Hi everyone. Today we're going to choose actors for our play. If you act well, you can be in the play.
It sounds exciting.
Mandy, you go first. Please play an old, successful businesswoman. Now, she's angry at her son's bad grade. okay. Stop. Now, it's your turn, Steven. Can you play a funny blind monkey? He's going mad because he's hungry. Okay, stop. Guys, take it seriously, okay? Are you sure you want to be in a play? You're driving me crazy. Are you ready, Alex? It's your turn now.
I'm ready. What role should I play?
A cute girl who is a little heavy. She feels lonely.
I will try my best.
Always careful when he crosses the street.
Got it!
Bravo! You can win an Oscar!
Thank you! So, can both of us be in the play?
No problem.
Woo! Are we going to play Romeo and Juliet?
No.
What about their parents?
No.
Their friends?
No.
So what roles are we going to play?
Because we already have Romeo and Juliet, their parents and their friends in the play. You can only play trees.
What?
Just kidding.
Wow, 又到了我们 More to Learn 的时间咯。我们今天收到谁的来信呢？原来是来自于台东的东东东东强先生。他想问什么呢？他想问说，
哎，舅老师，何谓 as busy as a bee？
Wow, that's a good question. 什么叫做 as busy as a bee 呀、啊？像蜜蜂一样忙碌，所指的是什么呢？ That means...Someone is very, very, very busy. 代表那个人呢、啊、是非常非常非常忙碌哦。那如果那个人很穷呢 ？Very, very poor. 那我们就可以说 That person is as poor as a church mouse. 就跟教堂老鼠一样的穷哦。所以啊，这些用法很有趣吧？不要忘了回去要再多练习几次哦。OK.See you next time. Bye.
Hello, boys and girls. This is your teacher, Richard. I have a sad story to share.Romeo and Juliet. Romeo and Juliet is one of William Shakespeare's famous plays. It doesn't have a happy ending. In this play, there are two rich families, the Montagues and the Capulets. They hate each other and often get into fights. In the Montague family, Romeo is the only child. He's tall and handsome. In the Capulet family, Juliet is also the only child. She's lovely and pretty. When they meet each other at a party, they fall in love. Later, they get married secretly. However, their marriage doesn't help solve the problems between the two families. Instead, it brings about more problems and even deaths. The poor young lovers also die in the end. After their deaths, the sad families are brought together and agree to end their fights forever. It is such a sad story, isn't it?
Oh, 可怜的罗密欧啊！如果有一天有机会，我当导演，我一定会改编整个故事，然后自己当男主角，给他一个幸福美满的大结局。哎，好像有一点太拔辣哈。不管了，就算不能当男主角，我也要找到我心目中的 Juliet。Are you Juliet？
This is a school for people. It takes care of those who cannot see. This is a school for blind people. It takes care of those who cannot see. My brother is 16 and I am 18. He is 2 years than me. My brother is 16 and I am 18. He is 2 years younger than me. Mrs. Huang has been very since her children moved to the city. Mrs. Huang has been very lonely since her children moved to the city. Rachel's parents are of her because she won first place in the race. Rachel's parents are proud of her because she won first place in the race. It is not to play at the table when you eat. It is not polite to play at the table when you eat.